Can you hear me, Tom? Can you hear me, Tom?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, people, we're going to get started here in a second. I hope everybody can hear me fine. Okay, that's the best. Last year, this is a long, long year. What are you about? About to get it cracking in about 5 minutes, man. Blast your chats. Glad you have experience trade on the line. He's about to give us some stuff. And I'm really grateful to be here. And I just want to spread the love. I got my notebook out. I'm ready to take some notes for sure. So, you know what I'm saying? Basically, I need y'all to just blast the chats. Let them know we live. Let them know it's about to be some value here. And let's get it going, man. That's all it's about, is spreading values, you know? So we're going to get about 4 more minutes and we're going to get rolling. Let's just get some people up in here so we ain't just, you know, the more the mass. Let's less the mass.
And the money's hard to make. So I've been here on their face right now. I don't let me in the crib, going crazy down bad. Baby, I took a half, she took the whole day and slowed down. Baby, we took a trip, now we on your block and it's like a ghost town.
Baby, we gonna get started in 3 minutes. 3 minutes, people. 3 minutes. We got about another minute for this call in. I mean, for this song in. We just gonna get rolling after this song. Should be about 4 minutes. So 504, we gonna get rolling. Y'all let them know. Let them know. What's going on, family? What is going on, family? Man, I'm just so blessed to be here, man. I put this together, to be honest. I put this whole little tour together because, you know, I'm trying to be better. You know, I'm trying to be the best I can be. And, you know, you have to learn from the people who know. So, you know, I put this call together to add value for sure. But at the end of the day, you know, let me just be honest. It was for me. And everybody's taking advantage of it. And that's the beautiful thing about this opportunity. You know, because I'm trying to get up as much sauce as I can. Everybody always say leverage, 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 leverage. Well, here I am. This is me leveraging. You know, got some good connects with some good people. You know, I'm reaching out. And I'm trying to just steady, consistently educate myself. Steady, consistently bring some type of value, not only to me, but to the people we come across, you know what I'm saying? And that's the beautiful thing about what we do, you know? And I'm just so humbled to be here, you know? But I'm gonna get into a little mindset, you know? Because the market is a beast. I just want y'all to know that, you know, if you don't train for a heavyweight fight, you will get beat up. If you don't train to hop in the ring, if you don't feel confident in your training, you know. So basically, you shouldn't hop in a market unless you feel confident in your training. You shouldn't be out here putting big lot sizes on something if you don't feel confident in your training, you know. So definitely make sure you train yourself to where you're feeling real confident and you have the mindset that I'm going to come in here and I'm going to beat the market. I'm going to be patient. I'm waiting on my opportunity. And I'm going to get mine. Because the market not going anywhere. They always say certain things are undefeated when it comes to the market. But a lot of people have ate off those same things. US 30 will take your whole account. Gold will take your whole account. Bitcoin, like stuff like that will take your whole account. I'm a witness and a person that's actually endured these endeavors. So if you don't come in with the proper mindset, with the proper attitude, you know, with the proper discipline, then you will get taken advantage of. Period. You know, and consistency is something I want to touch on today as well. Consistency is key. Everybody trying to come to market and make get rich overnight, get rich tomorrow, get rich in 20 minutes. You know, it can happen, but it really can't happen without consistency. You know what I mean? It can't happen without you being consistent. You know, first you have to train yourself consistently. Then you have to put yourself in a state to where you like, hey, okay, I feel good about these moves I've been practicing. I feel good about my trainings. You know what I'm saying? Like, wax on, wax off, Daniel, son. You know how long he was waxing cars before he actually was able to use that? He didn't even know what he was doing. He didn't even know he was training. He thought he was just being abused. And it can feel like that when you learn, when you educate yourself, you know? So be consistent in your trainings. Be consistent. And that's the key to success. You know, don't try to get all the whole bag in one scoop. Because if you can turn $50 into $500 consistently, then guess what? You can turn $1,000 into $10,000. It's the same thing. And I want y'all to understand, if you put $10 in your trading account, you can trade with that. And if you can turn that to $100, you can turn $100 into $1,000. It's not about the amount of money. It's about you staying consistent on doing the same thing. You wake up every morning, you brush your teeth, don't you? You don't even got to think about it. You don't even got to think twice. Well, for most of us, you know, for most of us, if you brush your teeth, just give me a 3 in the chat if you can, if you brush your teeth and you wake up in the morning. Give me a 3 in the chat if you just, you wake up and you brush your teeth. Thank you. That's how you have to be in the market. You have to wake up, you have to train. It has to be like nature. Because this is what we do. We trade. We build, yes, but then we're trying to get a bag both ways. You know what I mean? So you have to make sure you stay consistent in your training, stay consistent in your lot sizes and your investments, you know, because you can't get rich overnight. And just understand that if you can consistently flip $10 into $100, the money don't matter. The amount don't matter. If you can do it consistently, you can do any amount of money. It doesn't matter the amount of money. You know, don't get caught up with the money. The money's coming if you stay consistent. The money's coming if you stay disciplined. The money's coming if you train, if you educate yourself so you can put yourself in a position to be the best you can be when you hop in here with this beast. Because that's what the market is. It's a total beast. And if you don't understand that right now, then I don't know what you're doing on this call. You know, Stevenson Lindor said it best. If you ain't blown an account, I don't even want to talk to you. Because that's a feeling you get. I lost a couple bands in the first week I was trading. But I was excited about it. Then I put some more money in, lost that. But I was still with Juicy because I see it. It's there. The money is there. It's just I pushed the wrong button at the wrong time. Or guess what? Maybe I wasn't training. Maybe I wasn't consistent. That's what I did. I went back in the lab. Stopped trading. I just stopped trading, period. I ain't put no money. Who? Put a 3 in the chat if you ever said, I ain't put no more money in this account. I ain't put no more money in this account. Put a 3 in the chat if you ever said that. If you ever said, I ain't put no more money in this account, guess what you end up doing? Put some more money in that account. And you know you're going to do it. You feel me? So make sure you put yourself in the best position when you do decide to trade. Make sure you put yourself in the best position to win. We're not out here to blow accounts. We're out here to grow accounts. Somebody tap that in the chat. We're not out here to blow accounts. We out here to grow accounts. And that's what we, that's why this call is so important. That's why I'm doing this whole tour thing, because your network is your net worth. We have people here that's experienced traders that get money daily. And I just want to bring them to you guys so you can sharpen your tools. You know, so you can sharpen your sword. You feel me? So you can, you know, practice on your techniques so you can implement what they say or what they do and do it on your own. You know? So I just want you to know that you have to stay consistent because the market will eat you alive. And if you don't know that going into the market, you're hurting yourself. You're putting yourself in a bad position. If you don't know the market is here to take everything that you have, then you're not thinking right. Because you have to have that same mentality. I'm here to take whatever I can from the market. When it's blue, it's on you. Well, make it count. We're not here to blow accounts. We're here to grow accounts. You know, we're not hopping in the market without training. Make sure the education is there. The platform is there. The stuff you need to be successful is there. Not only is it there, it's in the chats. So if you can't win on IM Academy, if you're too lazy to hit a button, hit a link. If you're too lazy to hit a button, hit a link. Because at the end of the day, all we're doing is spreading the same information that we got. The same information that we got from the educational platform. We implementing it and we giving it back to you. So if you're too lazy to hit, you know, the go lives, because it's money everywhere. I don't know how you're not successful. And don't trade with everybody. You know, a lot of people have good percentages on trading. It's just that you have to trade with that person. You have to stay consistent to see those numbers. If you have a trader and he's 80, 90%, you taking 3 trades out of 10. How's that? How are you going to win doing that? You taking 3 trades from this guy, 3 trades from this person, 3 trades from GoLive. Stay consistent, even with educators. Stay consistent with somebody you like, and then you will see profits. You understand what I'm saying? So you have to educate yourself, stay consistent, take advantage of what you're paying for, and have the mindset of just, I'm going in here, it's a heavyweight fight, I'm not playing no games, and you focus on what you're doing, you know, and you attack the market, and you wait on your opportunity, you take it, you be patient. Because the money is here, all right? Dog felt me. Hey, be quiet. You know, my cousin, I don't know where that dog came from. I didn't even know the dog in here. But yeah, so I want you to just understand what's going on in the market. Understand that you must train yourself and you must hop on these go lives. Trade with the educators. Stay consistent with who you're trading with, okay? Stay consistent with your lot sizes. Stay consistent with your training. Stay consistent. Sharpen your tools daily. Okay, and we do have an educated trader online. I'm gonna introduce him right now. He calls out signals for Everybody Eats. He's been trading for over 2 years. He's made $8,000 in 3 days. Born in Charleston, South Carolina, currently resides in Columbus, you know, and he's also a graduate from Clark Atlanta University. So I want y'all to throw some love in the chat for Mr. Chuck McKinney. Let's get it up to him, baby. Let's get it up to him. Let's go, baby. Give him some sauce. Appreciate you hopping on the platform, baby. Can everybody hear Chuck?
Appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you, fam. Thank you, sir. Thank you for that introduction.
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. If you can hear me, go ahead and type 1111 in the chat. Go ahead and type 1111 in the chat. Indeed, indeed, indeed. Thank you so much. Thank you for having me on this call. I'm going to go over some diamonds real quick about this market, and then I'm going to give a little sauce for y'all to jot down and take notes and use on TradingView as well. Okay, so whether you're a beginner, okay, or whether you have some extensive experience in this market, hopefully you can learn something from me today. But first and foremost, I'm going to go over the mindset here. Let me share my screen real quick. All right. Let me know in the chat if you can see my screen. Just type a yes in there if you can see my screen. Okay, cool. All right. I want to go over this is what I call the diamond mindset. Okay. This is what I call the diamond mindset. All right. Now the market, whether you're in a stock market, whether you're in a Forex market, where you're doing option trading, okay? The market is a great representation of the currents of mass consciousness. What does that mean? It's a place where the trader witnesses a large amounts of money being transferred electronically. So you're watching human consciousness move masses of amounts of money, okay, electronically before your eyes. You're seeing the emotions of money in front of you. That's a big thing, okay? Now, you as a trader, the desires or the frequencies you have to win is also sent out into the market. So you are participating in this market. Even if you feel small within this market, you are participating with your frequency, all right? It's the microcosm of the world energy and its events happening globally. We're dealing with nations' currencies. We're dealing with national events. We're dealing with Donald Trump sending tweets affecting different countries' economies at the drop of a dime. Okay? That's big. It's easy to feel small in that environment. But it's also big because you put yourself in that path of that frequency to be able to see it, okay? And first, I'm gonna start off with this before I even go any further, okay? In the chat, all right? Because this has to do with diamond mindset. And I forgot, I should have did this early before I started, okay? I want everybody to type, I can do it in the chat. I can do it. Go ahead and type out, I can do it. You can do all caps, you can do lowercase, you know, saying match your energy in the chat. Type, I can do it. Now, the reason why I want you to type, I can do it, or even say it out loud to yourself, is because there was an MIT study that was done, okay? And it had to do with people's belief systems. And if a person went up to another person and told them that they can't do it, that they can't do it, it will take at least 16 other people to tell them that they can do it in order to neutralize the negativity of that can't. Okay? So I want y'all to remember that every single day before you even step into the market. Say, I can do it 16 times. And that will automatically eliminate a negative thought about that you can't do it before you even begin. All right? So that's a little nugget I want y'all to have, you know what I'm saying? And make sure you practice that on a daily basis before you step foot into the market. Same thing with stepping onto the basketball court. Same thing before you even take a test. I know sports players, what the best sports players in the world, okay? They don't think about fear whenever they're going up to the hole, okay? They don't think about fear whenever they're catching the pass over the middle, all right? They're in what we call the zone. All the superstars, all the all pros, all the all NBAs, LeBron James and Michael Jordans, they're in this thing called the zone. They're not worried about stop losses. They know the goal is to take profit. They know the goal is take profit. Okay? They know the goal is to score the basketball. They know the goal is to win the game and get that championship. They're in the zone. They're not worried about fearful things. That's the last thing on their mind. Their first couple of things on their mind is what they need to do to win. And they're not hesitating. They're not pulling out of a trade early because their coffee was too hot, okay? They're not, you know, hesitating to jump in the trade because they're scared that they might lose their money. They're taking calculated risk and they're doing it fearlessly, okay? Not overconfident, not over cocky, you know, because we know all the over cocky fighters, they're easy to get, you know, knocked out, okay? Not over cocky, not overly humble, but they are in the zone. And I want you guys to trade in the zone, all right? And if you follow this guideline, this diamond mindset, it will help you get into that zone, all right? So back to my diamond mindset. As a trader participating in this market, it can make us seem small since we're participating in a global market. It can make us seem really minute, all right? So what you have to do is set your tone towards winning rather than focusing on the lack of influence you have as a small trader trying to influence the market. Don't worry about that. Focus on your tone before you even enter the market. Your intuition sometimes will kick in and tell you when to buy and sell, okay? You start to learn by osmosis just by being in the market and being in the zone, okay? So don't worry about how big the market may seem to you. Worry about your tone as a market. Not a chicken little, not a chicken head, you know. Be bold, be courageous. And if you gotta imagine you got two dragons on your shoulder with you, okay, while you're trading, do that. That definitely helps me, all right? Now, as soon as you set your tone, you want to have this energy, okay, as if you're playing with the market, all right? So, prime example, I was listening to a young gentleman earlier today, because I always, you know, study things, and he was telling the difference between small accounts and larger accounts. When people have smaller accounts, for some reason, they want to get 200, 300, 400 pips each day, all right? That's, they're, like my man said earlier, they're trying to take, you know, $10 to 10 grand in a day, okay? But if you're in a smaller account, be okay with that $50. Be okay with that $50. That's an incredible increase, right? So once you get to an expertise level, once you've made $10, $20, $30, $100,000 in the market, now you can put $1,000 in the market and you just play with it. You can just play with it. Have the energy, I'm just gonna play, I'm just gonna run this up to 10,000. And that's how it feels, okay? Being in that zone, that's how it feels. It's like, oh, I'm just gonna play with this and run it up. Just like if you're in your demo account. When you have that same energy that you have when you're a demo account and you're doing it with your real account, your account will grow substantially, okay? So that's what I mean by play with the market. It will teach you where you stand and also how to evolve your own energy to match what is out there. You're watching the market move in waves. You're witnessing this. Find out where you stand within that, okay? Are you a person that's more geared to be a scalper? You wanna be in there, you wanna be out and go about your day? That's cool. If you wanna be a person that's in there intraday, that's fine as well. I also recommend that for smaller accounts. If you're blue by, you know, 11 o'clock that morning, you're blue. I don't care if it's $10 or $27. You're done. You're done for the day. You're blue for the day. That might not seem a lot, but let me tell you, if I said at your corporate job, right, at the end of 3 years or at the end of 2 years, based on performance, they could give you a $5,000 raise on your salary, type of eight in the chat if that would excite you. If you were at a 9-to-5 at a corporate job, that's a great raise to have, $5,000 raise to your annual salary, okay? Now, that $5,000 raise for annual salary, a lot of people go back to school to try to get that, okay? A lot of people have to work for 3 years in order to get that. Perfect attendance, never miss a meeting. All the reports are on point. You know, bought the boss some flowers one day, you know, just was good at the company softball team and, you know, use the boss's favorite or, you know, whatnot. Now that $5,000 raise, okay, what if I told you all you had to do was make $8.64 a day in the market? I'm sorry, $13.84 a day in the market. And that would be your $5,000 annual raise at your job. And that's just $13, $14 a day in the market. That's a $5,000 raise on your salary. So when you break down the numbers, you can bless yourself with a raise on your annual salary with small amounts of income every single day. All right? So back to my diamond mindset. Remember the current you felt when you won a few strings of trades. How many people in here had a week of trading where like you couldn't lose? Like you just went in 7 out of 10, 9 out of 10 trades. Like you were just on fire. You looked at your trading account. You're like, man, I'm up 1,100 for the week, or I'm up 700 for the week. I'm up, you know, $30 for the week. I'm feeling good. So remember that tone. Remember that energy. Okay. As that was unfolding, Okay. As that energy was unfolding, as you was on that winning streak, you were rewarded dividends by the market. The market rewarded you. You were feeling good while you were winning, and the market rewarded you with dividends. Okay. You weren't feeling bad when you were winning. You weren't feeling awful. You were feeling extremely good, and the market rewarded you with dividends. So always remember that tone. Try to remember that tone and trade with that tone. When you begin to trade, be patient. Be patient for that same good feeling that you had, that same tone that you have when you were winning over and over and over again. Wait for that feeling to come to you, whether you got to run a mile in the morning, where you got to eat a couple of apples, whether you got to call that girl you got a crush on, whatever you need to do to get that feeling first. Be patient for that feeling. Don't go into the market feeling scared. Oh, I got to make this money and pay this T-Mobile bill, or, you know, I got to do this, or someone's going to, you know, ask me for this money back. Don't go into the market feeling that way. You'll lose every time. All right. So be patient, gather your emotions, gather your feelings before you enter the market, because guess what? The patient man almost always gets paid. The patient man almost always gets paid. So be patient with your energy, get good energy, then enter into the market. All right. Now, next, those that experience the feeling of success and learn that tone, continue to practice that tone, and they keep winning. Have you ever ran into somebody and they just, you know, you're smarter than them. Okay. You know, you're more street smart than them, but they just keep on winning. And it's so annoying. You're like, man, how does this person keep winning? Like, she just joined yesterday and she done made 28,000 in a, you know, crazy. Like, why she keep winning? Why is that happening? I don't understand. I'm better than that person. I don't get it. I've studied longer than that person. I don't get it. Well, that's because they mastered that tone of winning. That's because they mastered that. They were patient for that good feeling, and they felt good when they got into the market. And every trade that they got into was the correct trade to get into, and it was in the right place at the right time and cashed out. Okay? That's what that means. All right? It may seem unfair to others, but they have ignored practicing that tone, okay? It's unfair to those that haven't practiced that tone. If you're not practicing feeling good, if you're not practicing feeling like you won a championship, you can't get mad at others that have, and then they win the championship, okay? All right, continue down. I'm almost done with these. All right, and like I said, recognize when it's there and when it's not. So if you wake up in the morning and your energy is not there, you have to have some indicators within you to let you know where you stand. And you say, you know what? I'm not feeling too good this morning. Stomach hurts, got the bubble guts. I'm gonna take today off. And there's nothing wrong with that, okay? But that's just an indicator, that's intuition, let you know, I want you to save your money today. Wait till the next day till you feel good. Nothing wrong with that. So recognize when it's there and when it's not. Pay attention to self first. Self-preservation is the number one thing in this market. All right. So at the end of the day, your real work as a trader is to practice that winning tone. That's your real work. Okay. I'm going to say there's a book called Trading in the Zone. And I immensely tell people to get this book. It's on YouTube, it's an audio book, okay? And they list a nice example, okay, about trading, two different traders. You've got two different traders that want to trade your money, okay? You've got one guy who has a simple strategy, okay? Might be a little mediocre, he might be like, oh, that's a little whack strategy you got there, but he's confident. He practices that good feeling tone. He's really confident in his strategy. He's consistent with his strategy. He uses it on a consistent basis, on a regular basis. He's confident, all right? And he's asking if you want me to use your money to trade. Or you've got another person, right, who does perfect markups, perfect analyzation, okay, has all the news reports in the world, coming to his phone, knows everything, has so much knowledge, it's too much knowledge. But he still has subconscious fears. He's scared to get out on the field. He might have all the Under Armour, Nike gear in the world. Got the best helmet, got the best visor, got the gloves, saying ready to catch like Odell. But for some reason, he's scared. He hesitates. He doesn't even run his routes correctly, even though he knows the playbook perfectly. Which person would you want managing your money? And I think the answer is obvious. All right. So, and the last part of this diamond mindset, all right, then I'll go over some trading view stuff. For some reason, we make financial things bigger than any other subject, okay? And we create the most fear of risk than any other subject, okay? For some reason, we make financial things bigger when it comes to creating fear-based mindsets, when it comes to risk to reward in our mind than anything else. And that's what makes trading harder for you. All right? If you just look at this as you're playing with the market, you're getting your energy good, you're seeing what's occurring within the market, you keep a simple strategy, as my man said earlier, pick one strategy, continue to ride it. We've got educators that are multi-million dollar traders for a reason. You follow that one strategy for a week, 30 days, you're going to see results. You're going to see profit. Do not make the market complicated with your emotions. And emotions, I mean fear. And emotions, I mean Chicken Little. And emotions, I mean when someone sends a signal, your first question is, what's the stop loss? Okay? what's stop loss, Chuck?
Yeah, let's take profit, Chuck.
Right. Right. Okay.
Somebody asked about that book you mentioned. What's the name of it again?
Oh, Trading in the Zone.
Trading in the Zone. That's
what's up. Trading in the Zone. I advise everybody to get that book or listen to the audiobook while you're running, while you're on the toilet, while you're on social media. You know, get that book. That helps elevate and get your mind state in a diamond mindset. All right. So real quick, let me switch over.
And at the end of the call, if you guys got any questions for Chuck, we will open the floor for you to ask those questions.
Yeah. One second here.
And I appreciate that that diamond mindset. That was dope.
Indeed, was indeed. Dope. Now, let me find my other screen here. All right, here we go. All right, cool. You see trading views on my screen? Okay. All right. Now, I want to give everybody some moving average sauce real quick. And then I'm going to show you the rewards for using these moving averages. So if you got a notebook and pen, I'm going to get a shout out to my boy, BK, graduate of Notre Dame University, actually helped put me on this game. he's actually trades cryptocurrencies full time. And a lot of this, I got from him, and I add a little bit sauce to it as well. And I'm going to share that with y'all. Okay. So first and foremost, I have three moving averages on the screen. I know it looks kind of, combobulated here, but I've got three moving averages on here. I have my white line, which is a 7 simple moving average. Okay. We call that the baby brother. All right. And I'm going to get into the reason why I have these in a second. I have the white, which is a 7. I have the blue, that's the 77 simple moving average, and that's the big brother. Okay. And then I also have this burnt orange here. That's the 231 simple moving day average. And that's the grandpa. That's the OG. Okay. Now, the reason that I have these moving averages, I know people heard of the 50-day moving average, the 200-day moving average, etc. Okay. I have these because if you ever heard of the Fibonacci, these are the Fibonacci equivalent okay, for moving average numbers, okay? So I've got my 7 short term, I got my 77 a little bit longer term, and then I got my 231. All right, now for my time frames. We got a question, hold on one sec. Okay, so if you know anything about the Fibonacci, Fibonacci basically measures, it's basically the golden ratio. It measures, supposed to measure human behavior. Whenever you put a Fibonacci on your chart, you can tell if it's going to make a golden retrace or if it's going to go up to the upside. It all measures human emotions, okay? It just marks different areas of human emotion within the market where price could potentially go. Just like I explained earlier, we're dealing with global energy, global emotions that are moving the markets. So we need to have a Fibonacci, which people call the God or the golden ratio, which everything on earth is measured upon. And it's a good measurement to see human reaction, human emotion. I could get into a whole 2-hour spill on that, but I implore you to, you know, look up Fibonacci numbers and sequences and look at the difference and the significance of those numbers, okay? So I'm gonna keep it simple for us today, and then you can go out and, you know, say, and do your research on that. Now, for the time frames that I have here, I have Fibonacci number-based numbers as well. Okay, my 3:43-minute chart is kind of similar to the 4-hour, right? But it's in Fibonacci time frame. I got a 77. Okay, minute chart as well. That's kind of close to your 1 hour. So whenever you're doing a chart, we all know the higher the time frame is the better point to do your markups on or do your support and resistance, okay? Now, yes, you set those yourself, correct. You come up here, all right? You come all the way down to the bottom, you can type in your custom time frames. You can do, you know, 77 minute, you could do 335 minute if you want to, etc. Okay, and you can do your own custom time frames here. You gotta go all the way to the bottom here. Mine's kind of covered up, but if you go all the way down to the bottom, you can type in your own custom time frames. All right, now, the reason why I have these on here, okay? You can, hold on one second, we got another question. Let me see. Yeah, absolutely. Now, the reason why I have these on here is because they had a competition, okay, with the Ivy League schools. They had a competition. They told all these potential traders and these first-year traders that were studying the market, they said, hey, we want to have a competition. We want to see who has the most accurate moving averages, okay, humanly possible. We want to see what's the most accurate moving averages that we can use to trade to make a profit. Now, out of all those students, out of all the results, these moving averages out-trumped all of them, outperformed all of them. Okay, out of all these Ivy League students and all their reports and all their research, these moving averages outperformed all of them, okay? Now, when the white crosses up above my 77, let me go down here. I'm on a 343 time frame. 343 minute time frame. When my white crosses, when little brother crosses above the 77, that's my indication to buy, okay? That's letting me know we're gonna go in a heavy uptrend. Now, not only do I have that, I have my Hakanashi candles, which I've added. If you know about Hakanashi candles, if you have a flat bottom green candle, that's letting you know more momentum to the upside, less ride. Okay, so look, it's crossed up here. And as you can see, as long as it stays above this 77, that's immense amount of profit here. Immense amount of profit. Okay, Now, what you can also do for your support and resistance, all right, is you can mark these yellow lines. I have historically marked where the 7 and the 77 have crossed, okay? So that lets me know where there might be some crazy resistance, where there might be some crazy support, et cetera. It gives me some targets, all right? Now, if you know about Fibonacci, you have Fibonacci here on the right side, that also can give you targets to the upside as well, all right? Or to set TPs if you have to walk away from your computer, all right? Now, when little brother, like I said, when little brother crosses up over the 77, and as you can see, it also crossed up over the 231 as well. That's the grandfather, right? When it crosses up over both of those, that means even more heavy momentum to the upside. And as you can see, this thing since July has been on an up tear, okay? And this is SPX 500, right? So now we see, how do we know we want to sell with these moving averages, okay? Now we see the 7 cross up under the 77. That's the big brother telling little brother, hey man, time to come back inside. You've been out too long. You know, grandpa's going to come get you, okay? Grandpa's going to come get you. You're going to get in trouble. So little brother's like, all right, I guess I'll go ahead and come back inside, you know, say I had my fun. Now once little brother came up under big brother, all right, what happened to SPX 500? We went down into a nice sell, okay? And little brother is coming back down to grandpa because grandpa's like, hey, it might be time for you to come in, little fella. And he came in. He's like, oh, nope, I'm not ready to go yet. And comes back up, but he doesn't cross up over big brother just yet. So he's in between big brother and grandfather, okay? So you could have still held this sell, okay? And that's the 7, the 77, and the 231, okay? Now, for potential profits, I had some marked up here on NASDAQ, okay? So every time this is crossed, okay, and this is on the 77. So if you want to do it on the hour chart, you can do the 77-minute chart, okay? And as you can see here, this is over 2,000 pips right here for NASDAQ. Okay, as soon as they cross, boom, took a ride on up. Now, as long as you have a target, you have a market, I mean, you have a target for profit, whatever, you can use the Fibonacci on the right side or you can use your own. You say, hey, I just want to get 200 pips, 100 pips, 300 pips, or do a trailing stop, do a 200 pip trailing stop. Okay, as soon as you got a candle close over this this cross, you get on in, you see a flat bottom green candle, Hakanashi candle, and then you just ride that thing on up, okay? Same thing for over here. You have the 7 going, you have the 7, the white, going up under the 77, the blue, all right? It went to a heavy sell. Not only that, it came up under the grandfather. And what happens when it comes under the grandfather? That means there's more momentum to the downside. Now, this thing is underwater. It's drowning. Okay, it's drowning, right? And as you can see, before it even came back to this moving average, that's a gazillion pips right there. That's crazy amount of profit right there. So you caught that. I mean, where's the yacht? You know, time to buy the yacht. Okay, and the same thing from over here. We had a cross back in August 20th, okay? And then also what you could do is look at your MACD at the bottom, see your MACD cross bullish at the same time, all right? And this is on the 77 minute, it crossed up, and we're gonna take that ride. Now here, it crossed down underneath, right? But it was still a nice little pips that you could have caught right here before it went back up to the upside, okay? But as you can see, when it breaks, it breaks. All right. And that would have been a 6,000 pip move right here. Okay. Over 6,000 pips. Boom. You would have rolled this thing all the way up. Okay. Probably might have gotten out here. Okay. When you got that wick coming or whatever, it might have wicked you out. okay? And you would have caught at least 6,000 pips using the high time frames. Now, this is a swing trade. So you would have held this, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, you would have held this trade for about 10 days. Okay, 7 to 10 days, you would have held this trade and made massive amount of profits. Me, myself, swing trades to me are the maximum way that you can make the most amount of money with the less stress, as opposed to trying to scalp. But if you have a smaller account, I recommend scalping, because a smaller account, you can't do swing trading. Okay? You can't do swing trading. All right? But anyway, I'm gonna wrap it up for that. That's my sauce for today. I enjoyed y'all thoroughly. If y'all got any questions, you can go ahead and answer them now. And we got a couple of minutes left on this call. I'm gonna let is the host still there? He walked away. Okay. Y'all got any questions? Let me know. Issa. Oh yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. If I get the setup, I'm gonna send it to you.
Yes, sir. Chuck. Hey, you gave up some good game, bro.
Oh, indeed.
Hey, bro, straight up, like, I didn't know what to expect, to be honest. I know you'd be over there calling out trades and stuff, but I like how you explain it. It definitely made it easy to understand. Oh, you got a lot of chats in a lot of questions in the chat. Let me see. What's the name of the indicator you use?
Yeah, I'm typing it up right now.
Okay.
This one's good too. You have to use.
Yeah, bro, that was very valuable. I appreciate that, man. I hope y'all was taking notes. I know I was. I definitely appreciate you, Chuck. Chuck, throw your Instagram in the chat as well, that people give you a follow. You know, follow Chuck. If y'all not in, everybody eat signal chat. I don't know what you got to do to get there, but. You know, hit up Chuck, hit up B. You know, they definitely bring a lot of value to what we're doing. Definitely. Okay. So if anybody got any more questions, you feel free to ask.
I do have a question. Those are EMAs or those are simple moving averages?
Simple.
All right, bet.
Okay, that's a bet. And the recording, I'm going to throw it in the chat. Chuck will have it as well. I'm going to put it in every chat that I'm in. So if you can get quality over quantity and top flight. And so if you guys want the recording, get it from Chuck, hit me up. As soon as it's done, I'll definitely send it over. Chuck, I really do appreciate your time today, brother. Any last sauce you want to give to people?
Like I said earlier, you can do it. You can do it. You can do it, set that tone, and yeah, be the tone, be that light, and that's it, man.
That's what's up.
Got it.
That's what's up. So I appreciate you, Chuck. We will be back Monday with B. Johnson. He is a six-figure earner in this market. We will have him on Monday. I'll definitely keep you guys posted. We appreciate your time today, people. The recording will be dropped in the chat. Much love, man. Y'all have a blessed rest of the week. Appreciate you, Chuck.
Indeed. Appreciate y'all, man. Love y'all.